Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. It's a good thing to be in service this morning from this platform. We give God praise and glory. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you this morning. We give you praise and glory. We worship you for a time like this. Thank you because you are the God of the universe. You have everything in your hands. You know all things, in the Bible say you can do all things. We thank you for the miracle of sleeping and waking. We thank you for all that is going on in the world. We give you praise and we say be thou exalted in Jesus' name. Father, we pray that this morning, as we share together your word, you will speak to us in the language that is very clear for us to understand. We give you praise and glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Good morning, my brothers and sisters, this morning. It's a wonderful thing to meet on this platform. We know all that is happening in the world, and I'm sure that Jesus has an answer for it. And as I was praying the early hours of this morning, you gave me a song. The song just came into my spirit, and that's what I will be taking off with this morning. The song, Jesus is the answer for the world today. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him, there's no other. Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the answer. So I want to encourage us. It's not a time to panic. It's not a time to be fearful. It's a time to actually, you know, get closer to Jesus. And, you know, as I was thinking about this meeting this morning as well, a scripture, you know, hits me. Psalm 34 verse 4. It says, I sought the Lord. So I want to encourage all my viewers this morning, those who are watching me either online or those who will yet watch later, that you should take this time of solitary confinement as a time to seek the Lord. Seek him in prayers. Seek him in worship. Seek him in meditating on his word. And I'm sure the Lord will bless you all in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, in the month of March, in our church, we've been looking at the word obtaining favor. And I'll continue in that same series. And today, we'll be looking at growing in favor. Growing in favor. Growing in favor. Our text remains Acts of Apostles chapter 2. And verse 47, Acts of Apostles chapter 2 and verse 47. The Bible says they were praising the Lord and they were, you know, growing and they were obtaining favor. Let me just read it so I don't paraphrase it. Acts of Apostles chapter 2 and verse 47. I just read it very quickly as we move on. Acts of Apostles chapter 2 and verse 47. The Bible says they were praising God. They were praising God. Acts 2:47 says, praising God and having favor with all the people. I shared last week that it's possible to have favor with just the king. It's possible to have the favor of man. But the Bible says having the favor of all the people, everybody, having the favor of all the people. So one of the things we should do in this time of solitary confinement is to keep praising God, and favor will locate us all in Jesus' name. Amen. I said this morning we're looking at growing in favor. And by definition, to grow means to undergo a natural development by increasing in size and changing physically, or to become greater over a period of time. Increasing, that's what it means to grow, to increase in size or to increase in weight, physically. So if we're talking about growing in favor, what we're saying is that we should develop in the amount of favor that is available to us. We should develop in the amount of favor that is available to us. Psalm 30 verse 5 says, for his anger lasts only a moment, but his favor lasts a lifetime. I was saying last week also that favor, the favor of God, is a lifelong thing. The favor of man lasts for a time.
it lasts for a season, but the favor of God lasts for a lifetime. Yes, the favor of God lasts for a lifetime, but we must change class in the favor of God. We must change in our dimensions, in the dimensions of God's favor. The amount of favor you and I are receiving last year should not still be the amount of favor we are receiving this year. We must change level. We must change class. The Bible told us in Luke chapter 2, verse 52, he said, and Jesus increased in wisdom and stature and in favor, both with God and with man. So Jesus grew in favor. Jesus grew in favor. You and I must grow in favor. In 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 26, the Bible says, and the boy Samuel continue to grow, both in stature and in favor with the Lord and also with man. And so, beloved, if Jesus increased in favor with God and man, Samuel increased in favor with God and man, or as it was written, continued to grow. You and I must also continue to grow in our favor with God. And don't forget, even in this season of solitary confinement, in this season of, you know, the pandemic situation in the world, we said last week that one of the things that the favor of God does is that it's a shield. The favor of God is a covering. The favor of God is a protection. The favor of God keeps you away from evil. And I'd like you to know, beloved, according to Psalm 5, verse 12, that as you continue to grow in the favor of God in this season, no harm, no evil is permitted to touch you. Coronavirus is not permitted to come near you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. And Exodus chapter 33, verse 13, Exodus chapter 33, verse 13, Moses said, if you are pleased with me, teach me your ways so that I may know you and continue to find favor with you and continue to find favor with you and continue to find favor with you. So Moses understood that he needs to have a continuous level of God's favor. He does not need just an amount of favor at a time and the favor is static. He needs to continue to receive the favor of God. And beloved, you and I also have a need to continue to receive the favor of God, to continue to grow in the favor of God, to continue to increase in the favor of God. And in verse 14 of that same Exodus chapter 33, look at the response of God to Moses. Let's look at that scripture together. Exodus chapter 33 and verse 14. Let's see what God answered him. And that's where we're going this morning. Very key. Exodus chapter 33 and verse 14. The Bible says God answered Moses when he began to ask him. Look at what God answered him. And he said, my presence will go with you. How can you and I continue to increase in the amount of favor we receive? Is by maintaining the presence of God, is by having access to the presence of God, is by seeking the presence of God. Moses was asking God that he wants to continue to find favor with God. He wants to continue to grow in his favor with God. And God answered him in verse 14. He said, my presence, if you want to continue to find favor with me, my presence is the key. And beloved, this morning, that is what I want to say to you. If you and I must continue to change levels in the school of favor, if you and I must continue to grow from one level of favor to another, we must constantly have the presence of God. We must constantly have the presence of God. Let's see the scriptures in Exodus chapter 34 and verse 9. Exodus chapter 34 and verse 9. And the Bible says, then he said, If now I found favor or grace in your sight, please go with me. Please go with me. The favor of God and the presence of God, they are two indivisible things. The favor of God and the presence of God, you can't separate them. Everywhere the presence of God is, there is favor. Everywhere the presence of God is, there is favor. And when you continue to have the presence of God, you will continue to grow in the school of favor. You continue to change level in the school of favor. Favor, as we have always said, is a sign of God's approval. Is a sign of God's approval. And so, beloved, I want to encourage you this morning that one cardinal point you need, or one cardinal ingredient, or one major thing, one pivotal thing you need to grow in your favor, both with God and with man, is to carry his presence. Is to carry his presence. Is to carry his presence. And permit me to say to you this morning, beloved, that the amount of God's favor, the amount of God's favor you carry is a function of the amount of God's presence that you have. Let me say it again. The amount of God's favor you enjoy is the amount of God's presence you carry. The Bible said, Titus chapter 2, verse 11 and 12. Titus chapter 2, verse 11 and 12. The Bible said, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation is appear to all men, is shown to all men, is shown to you, is shown to me. But we need to do something. The grace is available, but I need to do something to make sure that I'm changing level in this grace that has been shown to all. And what must I do, beloved? What must you do? Is to continually seek his presence. To continually seek his presence. How do I cultivate the presence of God? Is by spending time with him. How do I cultivate the presence of God? How should you cultivate the presence of a person? It's by spending time with a person. By spending time with a person. In Genesis chapter 39 and verse 21. Genesis chapter 39 and verse 21. Let's look at that scripture, Genesis 39 and verse 21. Let's see what the scripture says about God's presence. Genesis 39 and verse 21. Genesis 39 and verse 21. The Bible says of Joseph, he said, but the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. So you find out everywhere the presence of God is, favor cannot but be present. Everywhere the presence of God is, favor cannot but be present. Favor, the amount of favor, like I've said before, you have, is a function of the amount of the presence of God you carry. Let's see that scripture again. Genesis 39 and verse 21. And the Bible says, but the Lord was with Joseph. But the Lord was with Joseph. If you must carry the presence of God, you must spend time with him. If you must carry the presence of God, you must spend time with him. Spend time with him in prayers. Spend time with him. So I want to encourage you, this time of solitary confinement, compulsory one, you got to spend time with him. You got to spend time in the place of prayer. You got to spend time on your knees. You got to spend time praying. You got to spend time praising. You got to spend time, no complain, no complain. We saw in that Acts of Apostles chapter 2 and verse 47. I'm going to read it again. Acts chapter 2 and verse 47. It said, praising God and having favor. You want to have favor? You must continue to praise God. This is not a time to murmur. This is not a time to grumble. This is not a time to complain. If you want to have this favor, keep complaining. If you don't want to have the favor of God, keep complaining, keep murmuring. But if you want to have the favor of God and you want to begin to change class in the school of favor, you want to begin to change level in the school of favor, this is the time to begin to praise the Lord. Just like I said, the song the Lord gave me earlier as of this morning as I sought him. He said he's the answer. He's the answer for the world today. He's the answer for the world today. Permit me to digress a bit. I remember I was chatting, having a chat with one of our church members yesterday, and he was reminding me what God said to us at the watch night service as we took the Holy Communion from 1 Kings chapter 19. That God was saying to us, the journey of 2020, so that it will not be too much for us, we need the strength of God. We need bread from heaven, which is the word of God. And I said, wow, it means God has been speaking prior this time. I remember our father and the Lord was saying the title for the watch night service. Our father and the Lord, Pastor E. Adebo, was also sharing. He said, the battle is not yours. So, beloved, I want you to relax your heart. I want you to be calm. I want you to be cool. All you need to do at this time is just to begin to seek God. Just relax your heart, because no evil will come near you. No evil will come near you. I can assure you, no evil will come near you. For every single one hearing the sound of my voice, you're going out and your coming in is blessed. You're saved. You're protected. Why? If you can just carry the presence of God. Because God has told us before that the battle is not yours. The battle is not ours. I remember our father and the Lord was also saying, he said, if God said this is the year of victory, it implies that there's a lot of battle. I had my personal battle also. My mom fell sick the first week of January. And I was like, Lord, is the battle starting this early? But I know that victory is certainly sure for me. And I want to encourage all my viewers today as well. As you're listening to me today, are you going through one battle or the other? All you need is just maintain the presence of God. Just maintain the presence of God. And you can be sure that victory will be yours in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let me begin to round up. In cultivating the presence of God, I say you must spend time with him. Spend time with him. Mark chapter 1, verse 35. Mark chapter 1, verse 35. The Bible says, very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went up to a solitary place. What did he do there? He said, where he prayed. So at this season, don't always sit glued to the television set. Don't just be on your phone 24/7. Spend time. Get out of your busy schedule. The Bible said, Jesus got up. Get up from your busy schedule. Get up from that TV set. Get off from that phone and device that you're using. And get out of the device and spend quality time with God. Spend quality time with God. I remember jokingly these days, our father and the Lord will say, while he's preaching, he said, those who are old, if they sleep off, no problem. He said, because the Bible says those who are old, we have vision. So if you spend time praying this time and you sleep off, no problem. You wake up again, continue to pray, continue. Just ensure that you spend quality time. And what I want to bring out from here also is that it must be a deliberate attempt. The Bible says Jesus got up. It was a deliberate attempt. If you must cultivate the presence of God, it must be a deliberate attempt. Jesus got up. That was number one deliberate attempt. He left the house. Number two, deliberate attempt. He went to a solitary place. So you must have a particular place where you seek God. You must have it must be a deliberate attempt in seeking God. What should you do at such places? Pray. You must pray. You must pray. In Luke chapter 5 verse 16, Luke chapter 5 verse 16, the Bible says, yet he frequently withdrew to the wilderness to pray. He frequently withdrew. You must frequently withdraw as well. If you must cultivate the presence of a person, you must spend time with the person. If you must cultivate the presence of God, you must spend time with him. The Bible told us of Jesus that he frequently withdrew himself. So, beloved, I want to encourage you today. You must also frequently withdraw yourself and spend time with the Lord. Shut your door from your spouse. Shut your door from your children. Shut your door from your friends and spend time with God. Because everywhere the presence of God is, favor is inevitable. And when you keep maintaining the presence of God, when you keep, you know, developing the presence of God, you can be sure that you will keep changing level in the school of favor. You keep changing level in the school of favor. Before I round off this morning, let's read one more scripture. Matthew chapter 14 and verse 23. Matthew chapter 14 and verse 23. And the Bible says, after he had sent them away, he went up on the mountainside by himself to pray. He went up the mountainside. So you must learn to send away every distraction. You must learn to send them away so that you can spend quality time to pray. You can spend quality time to cultivate the presence of God. Can we this morning, beloved? I don't know if you're hearing the sound of my voice this morning. You have not surrendered your life to Jesus. That is the first thing to do. You cannot spend time with somebody if you have not initiated a relationship with the person. You cannot spend time with someone if you have not initiated a relationship with the person. So I don't know if you're hearing the sound of my voice this morning. You have not actually initiated a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. You can't spend time with him. If there's anyone like that this morning, I want to pray with you. If you're there this morning, I want you to just bow your heads and say after me, say, Lord Jesus, today I've come to you to initiate a relationship with you. Lord Jesus, please forgive me my sins. Come into my life. Save me my soul. Give me your Holy Spirit. Write my name in the book of life. Let your Holy Spirit begin to direct and to lead me. Thank you for saving my soul. I give you praise and glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. If you have taken that decision this morning, you have initiated a relationship, I want to encourage you. You must learn to read your Bible every day. You must learn to spend time with God. And number three thing that I want to say to you, you must also find a Bible-believing church. Too many churches today are doing so many things that are contrary to the scriptures. The scripture is our manual, is the textbook for Christianity. You must find a Bible-believing church. And number four thing, finally, that I want to encourage you to do, you must leave what you read or hear from the Word of God. And I'm sure that the Lord will bless you. Until I see you next time, God bless you and stay safe in Jesus' name. Amen.
Father, we thank you this morning. Praise and glory. Worship you for a time like this. Thank you because
so I can God share it to the page.
Oh, wow. Everything.
Why should you ask that?
No, just in case you
okay, I stopped that already.